Good day to everyone, Vitaly Sokolov is with you. Today we will talk about one of the most powerful and most multi-platform Pascal and Object Pascal compiler and programming environments for it. With all this, it is also open source and free licensed. And before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. On this channel you will find a lot of reviews on programming languages and environments, libraries and game engines, as well as educational videos on programming and interesting news. Give the video a thumbs up and leave a comment. Your support is very important. Thank you all in advance. Free Pascal Compiler is a powerful modern cross-platform compiler that is used by many programming environments, for example Free Pascal IDE, Lazarus, Code Typhon, MSE, Genie, FP Shell, Castle Game Engine and others. It can even compile text files created in Notepad. The compiler has been developed since 1993 and up to the present time. Compiler version 1.0 was released in 2000. Usually, new stable versions of the compiler are released 1 to 2 times a year, but there are exceptions. And unstable current versions can be downloaded almost every day. The author of the compiler is Florian Klampfel from Germany, and at the moment the entire international team Free Pascal developer team is engaged in development and the work is moving quite quickly. Therefore, the number of new tasks is growing and new programmers can offer themselves as junior specialists in the development of Free Pascal compiler. The official website provides a list of future features and ongoing work. There is a constant discussion of the compiler on the forum and on the bug tracker and by email, the development team receives reports of bugs that they try to quickly fix. SourceForge has named FPC Project of the Month 3 times, in 2014, 2017 and 2018. Now the compiler is being developed on github.com, gitlab.com and SourceForge. Also, this compiler is actively used in science, you can see some of these publications on the screen. We see that Pascal is used in such areas as mathematics and statistics, physics, chemistry and chemoinformatics, astronomy, meteorology and atmospheric research, geography, geology, cybernetics, biochemistry, computer science, bioinformatics, biophysics, ecology, genetics, zoology, microbiology, neuroscience, systems and theoretical biology, agriculture, archaeology, architecture and construction, engineering and technology, nutrition research, education, general methodology and tools. And others. Pascal is also actively used in medical science, infectious diseases, endocrinology, neurology, ophthalmology, pharmacology, psychology, radiology and others. This is facilitated by cross-platform, the ability to work with other programming languages, openness and free, as well as the presence of a huge number of examples and libraries. It is also important to support the syntax of various programming languages, as well as the possibility of programming in various programming paradigms. Free Pascal Compiler is released under the GPL and LGPL licenses, which allow you to freely use it even for commercial purposes. On the screen you can see a list of supported platforms and operating systems that are officially supported. So there are operating systems, support for which is still being tested or developed. The big advantage of the compiler is the ability to interact with C, JavaScript, assembler languages, and Java virtual machine support is also being developed. This expands the number of supported libraries and ready-made examples. Operator and procedure overloading is also supported. The compiler shows good compilation speed compared to modern competitors, with the ability to compile 16, 32 and 64-bit code. There is support for exceptions, RTTI, ANSI strings and generics. There is a fairly powerful and functional code optimizer. The system requirements of the compiler are very low, and the support for operating systems and platforms is huge, so you can work with it on many systems, even on very weak computers. Free Pascal Compiler has its own console shell, programming environment, Free Pascal IDE, which looks like the Ball and Pascal and Turbo Pascal environments, but if you wish, you can use other programming environments by connecting this compiler to them. This compiler has compiled thousands of applications of various types. These are games, game engines, database programs, utilities, components and libraries, educational, scientific and medical applications, software development environments, business and office applications, network, web, multimedia, social applications, operating systems and many other types. To work with the compiler, you can use one of the following programming environments: Lazarus, Code Typhon, MSE, FP Shell, Castle Game Engine, Free Pascal's own console environment, or compile projects through text files and PAR files, specifying the necessary compilation options using BAT files. If you have already installed Lazarus or Code Typhon, then some version of Free Pascal compiler is already installed on your computer along with them. The most flexible way to download Free Pascal compiler is FPCUP Deluxe. To download it in the search bar of the browser, you need to write FPCUP Deluxe. Go to the official website, select the operating system into which the download will be made and start the download process. Next, you need to run the downloaded file. If the Windows operating system blocks the file from running, you need to click View Additional Information and allow the file to run. When the program starts, you can close the first message, and then you need to select the version of Free Pascal compiler and click on the Install Only FPC button. If you just need to download the installer of the stable version of Free Pascal compiler, then in the search bar in the browser we write Free Pascal. Go to the freepascal.org website. In the general section, click Download. On the next page, you need to either select your operating system, or scroll down the page and in the source section click on the download sites link. You can also download the documentation there. On the next page, you need to select a server for downloading, or SourceForge. Next, you need to run the downloaded installer, select the type of installation. If you select custom at this stage, then you can check the boxes next to only the necessary items and the required amount of memory on the computer will be shown. The full version of the installation takes about 300 to 400 megabytes. We also select a place for installation. If the menu items in the start menu related to the compiler are not needed, then we put the appropriate mark and click the install button. After installation, a shortcut will appear on the desktop to launch the Free Pascal IDE. You can also download the source codes of the compiler by writing Free Pascal GitHub in the search bar of your browser, follow the appropriate link. Select the FPC source section. In this section, we see all the necessary files and directories, as well as the dates and times they were last modified. To download, you need to click the code button and select the download zip item. If you get an error, in this case, try enabling the VPN program or browser extension, or use the Tor browser. Next, your browser will download the archive to the default location, usually the download directory, or a message will appear asking you to select a download location and you will need to select a suitable free location. Also, if you wish, you can download sample projects and compiler documentation in the same way. Then it is enough to unpack the contents of the archive to a convenient place and you will be able to start working with the files and source codes of the compiler. When working with the compiler, to reduce the size of the binary code, you can enable optimization for supplied RTL, FV, FCL packages and for your own code. By using the XS command line option when compiling your program, disable symbol information. When creating smart apps to include generation of smart anchor units, use the CX command. Enable to link previously generated units available to Smalink using the -20 command line option when compiling the program. To remove the compiler, just delete the folder in which the installation was performed. That's all for me. I hope this video was helpful for you. If so, don't forget to put your finger up, subscribe to the channel and write a comment. This is important for the development of the channel. Vitaly Sokolov was with you. Good luck with your programming and see you in the next video.